Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have to stand before you this afternoon. I've been waiting patiently since yesterday and interacting with several others, so it's my turn now. But the last presenter has made my work very simple, and you will appreciate it maybe at a different perspective. It's more or less it's a similar work, but this was in Nigeria. So I'm talking on assessing the microbiological and the heavy metal burden in some freshwater and marine fishes in a segment of the Bight of Bonny, Niger Delta area of Nigeria. The Niger Delta area is one very important segment of the coastal environment in Nigeria. And within, you have the Bight of Bonny. The Bight of Bonny on the southern Atlantic coast of Nigeria, identified with that latitude and longitude. This coastal aquatic system is about 100 kilometers long and more than 30 kilometers wide. It constitutes the eastern flank of the Niger Delta, spanning the shoreline of Akwa Ibom, Cross River, and rivers. And I want to just summarize that by referring us to the figure one before us. That is the map of Nigeria, and the highlighted portion in the southern part is the Niger Delta. The Niger Delta is a very turbulent part of Nigeria because is a heavily polluted area. I mean, the coastal environment is heavily polluted because of a lot of oil activities, crude oil exploration and exploitation. So there is spill all the time. There's no year you don't have up to 3-4 spill incidents. And I happen to be a consultant to one of the big oil companies in the country. And so that is the Niger Delta, and the states that make up the Niger Delta, the nine states that make up the Niger Delta. And within these nine states, particularly this work was carried out in the Bight of Bonny, and that comprised rivers, Akwa Ibom, and Cross River, you know, taking care of that axis, the coastal part of Akwa Ibom State, and rivers, and Cross River. And then the sea is part of the Bight of Bonny, the Bight of Bonny. And it is this sea the fishes were harvested, you know. And then along the coast, you have different fishing communities, several fishing communities where the fishes were procured. The contamination of aquatic ecosystem with a wide range of pollutants has become a matter of concern in the Niger Delta area of Nigeria over the last decades. Like I said earlier, it's a turbulent part of Nigeria because when there is a spill and the community asks for compensation, the federal government, the state government, they refuse to pay, and the people will cause trouble. And a time came some many years ago, one of the principal an indigene of the area, Ken Sarowiwa, was murdered because of this kind of trouble. And today we have Niger Delta Commission in Nigeria that is taking care of the problems, trouble coming from that area. So you can see the seriousness of the matter arising from pollution arising from petrogenic and anthropogenic activities, because of urbanization and industrialization. Agricultural practices have increased the amount of heavy metals in the environment, especially in the aquatic ecosystem. The fishes are conditioned by their environment, and hence it is obvious that if the growing and harvesting environment of fish is polluted chemically or microbiologically, the fishes are also polluted.
Hence, the use of fish to evaluate the health of aquatic ecosystems, because pollutants build up in the food chain and are responsible for adverse effects and death in the aquatic systems. Now, it has been established that the microbiological and heavy metal load of fish is a reflection, it's a true reflection of the contamination level of the habitat, and thus a potential indicator of pollution. And so this work was carried out to establish the contamination level of aquatic systems and in line with the fish, that is aquatic resources, where they inhabit. Just to make you appreciate what I said earlier, this is the kind of thing that is happening in the Niger Delta and the Bight of Bonny. You see a lot of gas flaring and release of toxic chemicals into the environment. Some of them will come to precipitate and all end up in the water. And from the terrestrial environment, during runoff, all other things, waste from domestic and industrial sources end up in the water body where the fishes are. Now, because the water is so contaminated, you can find oysters. Normally, they're supposed to adhere to mangrove, but this area has been taken over. The original mangrove, the white and the red mangrove, are no more. So what we are having now is Nipah palm. Nipah palm has taken over this aspect of the country. And so you find these oysters attached to Nipah palm instead of getting interacted with the original mangrove. The original mangrove is no more there. And these are just samples of the fish, fin fish, and the scaly fishes that we determined we use for the work, and then the crabs. You have also seen the fishing gear there. The main objective included a quantitative and qualitative microbiological assessment. That is, we determined the microbial load and also isolated the organisms, purified, characterized, and identified them using standard microbiological criteria. We worked on the sediment, the water, and the fish samples in fresh water and marine water. We also determined the physicochemical characteristics of sediment and the water, as well as heavy metal concentration and total petroleum hydrocarbon degrading microorganisms in the different samples. Our interest really was to look at the level of petroleum hydrocarbon degrading microorganisms in fish. Why is it that despite all the pollution, despite all the trouble, this area has been so challenged, we still find fishes in the water? It means, therefore, that the fishes must have adapted themselves to the stress, the oil stress, and we were thinking that there must be some degraders in the fishes themselves. So we tried to go into isolation of petroleum hydrocarbon degrading microorganisms in the fish themselves. I said earlier we worked with the water, sediment, and fish, looking at the physicochemical criteria, heavy metals, and culture-dependent analysis. We looked at the coliform, total heterotrophic microorganisms, and then petroleum hydrocarbon degrading microorganisms. Before us is the list of fish samples and their local names with the different weights from fresh water and from fresh water and marine water. Yes, marine water and freshwater fish with local names and weights. I may not be able to read the names, but you can appreciate them. We also carried out the physicochemical characteristics of fresh and marine water samples and compared the values with standards. That is the World Health Organization standard. We compared the values with the freshwater values and marine values. Physicochemical characteristics of marine and freshwater fish. This is the case for fish, the story for fish. freshwater fish resource and marine water fish resource compared with the World Health Organization standard. We also looked at the distribution of the different physiological groups of microorganisms from marine and freshwater fish. You can see the THC is total heterotrophic count, total coliform count, petroleum hydrocarbon degrading count, and total fungi count. All through the microbial load in marine water, you know, was higher than the rest of the physiological groups, which were relatively lower. Next is the distribution of different physiological groups of microorganisms from marine and freshwater sediment, because all the wastes and what they carry at the end of the day will sink into the bottom of the sea. So we want to look at what happens to the environment in that direction. So we find out the total fungi count higher in the marine environment, that is sediment. Petroleum hydrocarbon degraders also higher there in marine. Total coliform count higher in marine environment, and total heterotrophs higher in marine environment than the freshwater environment. We also looked at the distribution of different groups in fin fishes from freshwater. And that is the, you know, fishes are filter feeders. So we looked at the gills, intestine, and the skin. Ordinarily, you would have probably feel that the gills should have more, since they receive the material first from the water through the opercula. But you find out there from the resource, the skin tended to harbor more organisms than gills and intestine, followed by the intestine, you know, respectively, as presented. And that is a distribution of different groups in shell fishes from fresh water. And we found out that the skin equally had elevated microbial load compared to the intestine and the gills. Here we find out that the fin fishes from marine water harbored more organisms equally in the skin, you know, when compared to the intestine and the gills all through. Next is distribution of different groups in shell fishes from marine water, the skin, gills, intestine, following almost the same trend, except here where you have equal number of organisms, but the total heterotrophs were elevated there in the intestine. Heavy metal concentration in freshwater and marine sediment. This is simply presented here. You find in marine environment you had elevated values compared with the freshwater environment as presented. Concentration, heavy metal concentration in fin fish parts, that is the skin, gills, and intestine. You can find the elevated level of iron and followed by zinc in the case of intestine and the rest as presented. Next was heavy metal concentration in fin fish parts from fresh water. You find very elevated level of iron in the skin and then zinc in the intestine. Very interestingly here, lead and cadmium that are very toxic, carcinogenic, and mutagenic to the body were marginally present, but the iron there, which we are not so much afraid of iron because already it's in our system. Next was heavy metal concentrate and shellfish parts from fresh water. Similar train, iron very high everywhere, and the rest were marginally present. Next was heavy metal concentration and shellfish parts from marine water. We find the same similar train with the little or no lead. And my conclusion, the study on the whole evidenced the microbial and heavy metal status of shell and fin fishes found in fresh water and marine ecosystems. It also confirms the fact that both shell and fin fishes remain a promising option in biomonitoring and pollution assessment in lengthy aquatic systems. Some microbiological analysis, such as heterotrophs, the coliforms, the petroleum hydrocarbon degraders, and total fungal count, were performed on different fish organs, water, and the sediment. The heavy metal concentration in these fish organs vary directly with the concentration value in water and sediment as obtained in this study. The presence of petroleum hydrocarbon degraders like Chromobacterium, Bacillus subtilis, Candida albicans, Micrococcus in the fishes presents some ecological advantage in the event of oil spill, as the degraders in fish could multiply and biodegrade the pollutant for their survival. Thank you very much for listening. Just time. Oh, thank you very much.
We have time for a question or two, please.
How do you calculate the problem with the shell, or is how do you?
Yeah, we use the vapor phase transfer technique by culturing. We cultured it using the vapor phase transfer technique. Yes, by culture.